Minister, welcome to Channel Africa. Okay. Minister, welcome to Channel Africa, and we thank you for giving us this august opportunity to talk to us after your busy schedule. Minister, if you could tell us more as to what would you say is the significance of this COP17 workshop with your office and the SABC.
Okay. You know, we are in charge of communications in the presidency, but also responsible for performance monitoring and evaluation. One of the responsibility that we have is that we have to monitor work that is done by government, and where we think there are challenges and where we think there are gaps, we then recommend possible solutions and sometimes also intervene. So when we were watching the space and trying to monitor work that is done, we realized around COP17, we then realized that there is a space or a gap in relation to awareness and mobilization of people. As much as the ministries, the content ministries have been doing a lot of work, we thought it also part of our responsibility to assist them to accelerate awareness of the conference. And therefore, we have had other conferences, you know, or workshops where we have met with journalists and government communicators, where we have workshopped women and other sectors. But eventually we realized that without the SABC, we will not necessarily be able to get everybody else to participate, because we know that the SABC itself has a lot of listenership, and therefore a lot of people listen to radio on a daily basis and other people watch television. And we thought that if we were to partner with the SABC, then we will probably get to as many people as possible.
Mm-hmm. And Minister, coming to the understanding of the impact of climate change, how far have we gone in conscientizing our people, as it was with other events that took place in South Africa, like the World Cup and other related activities?
Look, I'm happy that we are raising one of the activities that we have had, which is big occasions that we had. For an example, the 2010 FIFA World Cup. You know, with the FIFA World Soccer World Cup, we were mobilizing people to go to the stadiums to go and watch. They would go there and be spectators. I was one of those spectators who would sit there and watch the boys playing. The difference with COP17 is that you don't want people to be spectators. You want people to understand, because it's about their lives, it's about the health of the environment, and therefore they must be participants. They must participate. And therefore, for people to participate, you must then educate them, make them aware of the challenges of climate change. They must understand why we are hosting this conference. They must also understand that why, as a country and as a region and as a continent and the world over, we think that it's quite important to host, to educate people on climate change. Now, we have tried our best to try and educate people. As I said earlier on, ministers who are content ministers, the Minister of Environment and Water Affairs, the Minister of Agriculture, the Ministry of Energy, the Ministry of International Relations and Cooperation, as you would know, that that minister is taking up the position of presidency of COP17 this year when we host. They have gone out there to educate people. But I want to say one or two things. I'm not a specialist in environment and in climate change issues. My responsibility is to make sure that we move and make people aware. But just to cite one or two examples, I think as I sit here, when I look at the weather, it's very unpredictable, unlike the days when I grew up. I mean, I grew up in the house of my grandfather. We had a piece of land. We knew when was a season to plow, and my grandfather would be ready, and he would then take us to go and plow. But today, I don't think that we know exactly. We are almost towards the end of October. We still don't have rains. Instead of having rain, we have hail, you know. During those times, we knew that in October we would have rains, and we would then begin to prepare to, you know, to plow. But today, I don't think that we know. But also, the other example is that, you know, if I were to make an example with Mpumalanga, where I come from, or Eastern Cape and the Western Cape. In Mpumalanga, we knew that, you know, in November, we were going to plow millimil. And the Western Cape, knew that during winter time in June they were going to then plow, you know, your grapes and what. Now I don't know whether we must change, because now there are rains in the Eastern Cape during winter, and there are no longer rains in the Western Cape. Whether we should be changing and say people in the Eastern Cape must then begin to plow grapes, and then the people in the Western Cape plow millet. I don't know, because it then shows how the effects of climate change. These are the examples that I can give. I mean, just recently, I don't know whether it was in September or August, we had a huge snow in all areas. I remember that I was supposed to go to Harrismith. On the way, we couldn't continue, and trucks were parking all over the roadside because we did not expect that. And who would have thought that in September you would have snow in South Africa? So I think there is so much in front of us that people should understand that shows that there is something that is a problem, and that is a problem of climate change. You know, floods that we always have. I think that we also have droughts at some point. So people must understand that we really have to save tomorrow, today. And it is our responsibility as government. And I think that together with the public broadcaster, we can do a lot, because the responsibility of the public broadcaster is to educate, is to inform, as well as entertaining. And I think that probably we can use different ways of entertaining people, but on the other hand, educating them so that it's not boring, you know, to talk about climate change issues.
Mm-hmm. And Minister, the commitment that was made today, what's your comment on that?
I think it's quite a good commitment. The SABC committed to working with us as government, and they said they think that they're going to use every available opportunity and every relevant platform, you know, at their disposal and at our disposal together to raise awareness on climate change without compromising their editorial independence. And I think that that's quite important. But that they're also going to participate as representative of public broadcasting in South Africa to inform and educate the society on climate change. So I am quite excited about the commitment that we've come out with at the workshop that we've held here today, the SABC.
Mm. And lastly, Minister, you mentioned that a number of events have taken place prior to this COP17, where we are going in November and early December. I would like to find out as to what would you say is the awareness of the women in South Africa with regards to the impact of climate change, as they are the ones who are bearing the brunt of some of these scourges.
Look, I think that women in South Africa have been educated a lot. And I don't want to claim that every South African woman has had an opportunity to participate in our workshops. But we have had workshops in all provinces. These content departments have gone to all provinces. I have been fortunate to participate in two of them. I participated in Limpopo, and in that conference in Limpopo, I must tell you that I learned so much from women. You know, the indigenous knowledge that they have about climate change, that we never tap on it, and we think, you know, women don't understand. They understand very well. I learned a lot from that. But we also had in September, I think early September, the first week of September, we had a women's conference on the journalists and the media that are coming from different media in the country. And in that conference, in that workshop again, you know, I learned a lot. So I think that women have so much potential. And I think that if we were to workshop more women, our children will learn more, because it is women, as you are saying, that bear the most of the brunt. But they are also, you know, the people who stay with our children on a daily basis, and they are the best educators I can ever find in any country. You know, they have better way of educating children. So I think for us to save our tomorrow today, it helps that we teach women more. You know, if I were to use an example that happened, the recent example of Somalia, it's not a good example to use. It's a very sad situation. But the example is that of women is that every time, every corner, when you watch TV, you saw women suffering. You saw women, you know, holding children that are hungry, children that are sick because they have not eaten. So we must never sit here and be and be illusioned and think that you know, it will never happen in South Africa. So we really have to make sure that we educate our women, but we educate our children to save their tomorrow, because we may not be here 50 years down the line, but they are going to be here. So they also have to be educated so that they can prevent, you know, the disasters of climate change. And I think if we were to do that, therefore, and even the SADC region and the whole continent of Africa, because we are, you know, developing countries, and therefore we really have to make sure that our children understand what the effects of climate change exactly.
Minister, thank you very much for giving us your time. Looking forward to talking to you as we going towards COP17.
Oh, thank you very much, and thank you for having me.
Thanks, Minister.